So let's talk about that, where we stand with vaccine eligibility and all of our rollout. Joining us now, Mayor John Tory. Good morning to you, Mayor.
Hi, Mel.
We were having a positive discussion, Sid and I, earlier, that a lot of people are starting to feel optimistic. It is good to see some of these stats here, that these vaccine appointments are going very fast here in the city of Toronto. But then it begs the question of, do we need more? And a lot of people were asking yesterday when Peel Region said, we're going to open up to everyone 18 plus, will Toronto follow suit?
Well, we have adopted a policy, and it's reflected in what we're doing today. When the eligibility is opening up today to people 50-plus, we have allocated another 60,000 appointments, and they are also available at the same time online. But the reason it's 60,000 as opposed to 80,000 or 100,000 is because we only allocate and make appointments for vaccine that we are, you know, certain to have. Because what we don't want to do is make an appointment and have to cancel it. And so that is what we have done. I'll be interested to see how Peel deals with taking it all the way down to 18, knowing that they face the same supply issue we do. I mean, we do not have enough vaccine supply at the moment to match the capacity we have to give injections. We could open up a lot more than 60,000 appointments, but we don't have any guarantee there'll be vaccine. So there's no point in making an appointment for somebody if there isn't vaccine to give to them. And so that's the approach that we've taken. And, you know, we'll, if we get assurance of more supply, we'll open up more appointments immediately. And we're shifting the supply around as best we can, knowing that not all of our supply goes to the clinics for appointments. It also goes into these mobile and pop-up you know, in fact, most of it, the majority, is going to the mobile and pop-up in the hotspots, which, again, we have felt is the right thing to do to direct and target the vaccine to the areas where the virus continues to spread so as to stop that spread, because that's really what's going to get us out of this mess.
Mayor, when it comes to the supply, so we know that a lot of vaccinations or vaccine doses are being reallocated, obviously, to the hot zones during a certain period. Will the city be asking for more to be reallocated to Toronto once that period is up?
We have, because we've had this period where we've been getting a share to address the hotspots better, and we have asked for more on a continuing basis. And so I guess the province makes those decisions, and they make a decision as well as to doing something like opening up the system to 50 plus this morning, which will make a lot of people happy that they can get themselves on the list. But again, I mean, as you make all of these changes, one has to take into account the supply of vaccine, because there's no point in making people eligible only to find there's not vaccine. So yes, we believe that there should be a continuing allocation of vaccine based on the infection rates and the hospitalization rates and the ICU rates, because you know, are going to go to the place where things are most intense in order to try and beat this thing down. So yes, we've made that request, and they have a lot of different competing interests they have to try and satisfy. And so these are not easy decisions.
Some big news with Pfizer Health Canada approving it for youth, 12 to 15. We know it's already approved for 16 above. Have the conversations already started on what a rollout could look like for the younger generation here in Toronto?
Well, this just came about yesterday when Health Canada made the announcement that 12, I think it's 12 to 16, you said, can be vaccinated with the one vaccine. And so now I think it's going to be, again, the prioritization of who gets vaccinated when is entirely set by the province. And so they will, and I think it will make sense to have some sort of province-wide determination here as to how you deal with that age group. So as yet, yes, the discussions have begun, but as yet there's no conclusion as to how that particular age group will get vaccinated and when.
Sid Sixero's, one of his favorite topics here is active TO. We are going to have some more active TO closures happening this weekend. I don't know if you caught his rant last weekend. He's listening. His mouth is wide open right now because I'm calling him out. But there are fans of active TO, and there are people who say, do we need to be doing this? And it's crowding some streets. You've been a big fan of active TO. And so why do you say it's a positive in where we are right now?
I assume, just kind of surmising about Sid, that he was against it. But having said that, you know, we can talk about that another time. But, but it arose simply out of a very, very keen desire we had to make sure that people had safe space. And that means enough room to be outdoors and not be crowded together. And even in some of the places like the Martin Goodman Trail along the waterfront, there was such crowding in terms of people who wanted to be out running or on their bikes or so on, that it actually was potentially risky for health. And so we started it last year in order to give people the space by having this extra road space available on weekends and limited hours. And we are continuing it this weekend with the eastern part of Lakeshore and Bayview Avenue. We've announced that next weekend, not the one coming up, but a week, 10 days from now, we'll be opening Lakeshore West, and we're going to try that. There are serious construction matters going on this year that make it more complicated, but we're going to see how it goes. And we've also made, I think, what is a very exciting announcement, namely that on June the 6th, we're going to close the Allen Road and let people up in that part of the city use that road for biking and strollers and all the rest, just to see how that goes in a place that isn't downtown. And so I think it's a program that fits the desire people have to be outside, to get some exercise, to do it safely. And also, I think people's changing desires as to how they want to see our public space used, especially on times like weekends.
Okay. So there you have it. Mayor Tory, as always, we appreciate your time. Please do stick around, because it's been some time since we've done this time. Here it is.